Good morning, guys. So good morning, good evening for those who are joining in from other locations. So basically, we have been discussing about our company and the various trainings that we are offering, right? So the intention and the purpose to organize this webinar was to understand about what is IoT and how it is going to shape up the future, how it is going to bring up more avenues for the jobs, and how it is going to help us in our day-to-day activities going forward, like how it is going to help you in terms of changing our lives, right? So basically, my name is Rahul Deshmukh, and I have been into IT field for last 21 years. And in terms of IoT, I'm an IoT enthusiast, and I have implemented various solutions for different customers. So already since we have been implementing this, so what I feel is like whatever technologies we have, right? Like whatever technologies we have about the new age technologies like artificial intelligence, IoT, big data. So all these different technologies are going to change our future with combiningly they have a great amount of potential, right? So let us try to understand them. What exactly is IoT and how it is going to help us? So when we talk about IoT, what exactly is IoT? So when we talk about IoT, it is going to redefine the future. And this is a technology which is going to connect the unconnected. So when we say connect the unconnected, what exactly does it mean? Now, let's say you have been using the various systems nowadays, right? You know that we have the various IT systems where we are using it for ticket booking, for online portals, for generating any kind of tickets, booking the tickets, right? So all these different IT systems, already we know that they are connected, they have established the internet, and we are making use of the potential of this internet. But there are certain devices in our day-to-day life which can have the potential, which have the potential to change the way we are working, but they are not connected as of now. Like if I want to talk about those systems, like for example, you might have an air conditioner at your home and you want to understand the temperature control for that. You want to understand how to operate that whenever, in case of your presence or absence, you want it to be automated, right? So whenever you are not present in the room, then the AC should be powered off. Whenever you are present, it should be powered on. So those kind of things, you want to make it possible. So there are various solutions. Air conditioner example I have given is a very small solution, but there are various industrial benefits, industrial solutions, which we can make possible using the Internet of Things. So when this term was coined in the beginning, like around 1960s or 1999s, we had Mr. Kevin Ashton, who was visualizing this IoT, but his visualization was with the using of RFID as essential element to Internet of Things. But of late, it has been identified that RFID is not going to serve the purpose. And there is a different approach which is required, and a different method in which we have to connect these devices is required. So that is where this new type of Internet of Things, or the way in which the connectivity is established, has been changed. And that particular connectivity is using our electronic sensors, getting connected with Raspberry Pi board, Arduino board. We have established the Internet of Things, where these sensors, when integrated with Raspberry Pi, when connected with Raspberry Pi, help in conversion of these presence or absence kind of signals, or detection or absence of a person, into actionable output. Like, for example, let's say you have air conditioner at your home, and now you have moved out from that particular room. Like, you have come out from your bedroom and your air conditioner is on. Now, the moment you step out, the air conditioner will be switched off. Now, here you might be saying, already we have, that is a simple solution. What is Internet of Things in this? It is not just about powering on or powering off. Here, basically, Internet of Things establish the connectivity of such devices. It helps in trying to manage and monitor how much power consumption you are doing. It helps you in controlling the various parameters of that air conditioner. Right? So these are the various other actionable parameters which you can configure, which you can set, and which you can monitor on a regular basis. Okay. So basically, when we talk about this as a small example, so IoT here is a network of all devices, vehicles, home appliances, anything that you want to get connected, you can establish connectivity using this IoT. So this IoT as technology, it will help in interaction of these devices, exchange of information among each other, and also make sure that they are being monitored, managed, and controlled from a central location. So in general, like, let us say, if we want to apply this, if we want to use this technology in terms of a factory or an industry, then how it would help? Like, suppose, for example, you are establishing this IoT in an industrial setup, right? So you may want to understand how much power consumption is happening, and in case of the machinery, whatever you have implemented or installed, you want to make sure that they are being used by specific personnel during specific time zones or timelines, and you also would want to monitor how many such different kind of manufacturing of products is happening, what is the timeline, how much units of manufacturing is happening within that number of 8 hours, or whatever you may fix, or you may be per shift you want to monitor and manage. So all these kind of things can be applied into at industry level, where, like, you might detect the presence or absence of a particular personnel who is operating the machine, and you want to measure the per unit production, and ultimately, in case of any absence of a personnel, you may want that the machine should not be powered on, so that the electricity consumption can be avoided for that particular time frame when the personnel is not available. So that kind of industrial IoT implementations can help you in various ways. Now, in terms of the other things what you can do using this solution, is like, the different machines can interact with each other, they can exchange these parameters with each other, and you can also identify whether there are any preventive maintenance that is required for a machine, And that can be done using the sound analysis, what we receive from the respective sensors, what we have connected. So these kind of different aspects, different things you can apply in terms of the industrial applications. Now, when we talk about the individual consumer and its application, like nowadays you are already seeing, we have the variables in the market, right? So you are able to see how much you are walking using these variables. It is monitoring your steps, it is counting your steps, and you are able to find out what is your BP when you are running, when you are jogging, right? So all these different aspects as a consumer, you are able to identify and you are able to count. Okay, so there are certain questions which are coming up. Yeah, so let me take up these questions. Okay, we have a question like, how many customers in market wants to use this technologies and who are them? So right now, all these IoT applications are being targeted for industrial purposes, and we are already seeing that you have the driverless cars, right, which you are seeing as a potential use case for this IoT. So there is a lot of research going on. In terms of agriculture also, it has been implemented, and there are many other areas or domains where already the industries have started implementing it. Okay, so that is what I was talking about. And in terms of the commercial use cases, we can also implement for smart healthcare. Why it is called, okay, I have a question like, why it's called IoT instead of automation or control systems? Okay, basically this is called as IoT because we each and every device which is not connected so far or which is isolated in nature, it is known as a thing in the Internet of Things parlance. So since we are calling any element, any object as a thing, because we are enabling internet and enabling their communication, that is why we are calling it as Internet of Things. Right? Yeah. Mr. Arvind asks, how do you see IoT in the span of 5 years? Mr. Arvind, I will come to that point because we have that detailed slide about it, like what is the growth of the IoT. So we will talk about that. And Mega is asking about how in agriculture. So in agriculture, like, see, nowadays you all know that whenever the farmers want to sow the seeds, they depend totally upon how much rain they are getting, right? And they really do not know the potential of their soil. What is the kind of moisture content in the soil? How much is urea required for the soil? So in that case, right, we insert different sensors. We have soil detection sensors, we have humidity detection sensor. Using those sensors, we collect the inputs, we analyze their soil, and depending upon that, we can suggest them as to how much urea can really be used. Excess of urea also kills the crops, and excess of urea damages the fertility of the soil. So this input can help them to a great extent in trying to sow the seed as per the requirement, as per the inputs which are scientific in nature. Okay, so that way it will help in agriculture. Kamlesh asks, what are the set of skill sets required to become IoT specialist? In order to become IoT specialist, you just have to understand the basics of electronics and the basics of the electronic circuitry. And in addition to the electronic portion, we have various other skill sets what you all guys are already possessing. Like, for example, we need developers in this, we need database administrators in this, we need integration experts in this. So like that, we have got requirements of various people who can contribute to this IoT field and take it forward. So it is absolutely not something which you do not know. Already, if you are working in these respective fields, if you are working in data analytics, if you are working in database, if you are working with the different applications, then you can contribute to this IoT field. Tejaswini asks, what is the exact difference between IoT and AI? Basically, IoT is Internet of Things, where we are establishing connectivity. The first important thing is connectivity of those devices which are so far not connected. Like, for example, if you want to connect your washing machine to internet, that is also possible. And when it comes to artificial intelligence is the programming and using the various algorithms to identify the various predictive mechanisms, predictive analytics we can perform. So AI is purely about analysis. Okay, so artificial intelligence is used for analysis, for classification, okay, and for the various other objectives. But here, Internet of Things is establishing connectivity and exchanging the information among those devices, among those equipments. So that is the difference between AI and IoT. Neha asks, how IoT helps in aviation industry? So basically, Neha, whenever we are seeing the various aviation related accidents, right? So there we can use this IoT, and IoT can also be used to identify the various parameters. Like, for example, there is some variation in the weather, so suddenly dynamically there are changes, and there is some storm brewing after few number of kilometers, right? So those things can be provided as input, even if you whatever the aviation these things are used, right? The various detectors, various sensors. So even if those sensors fail, we can still rely upon the IoT based sensors in order to overcome the problem. Yes, Srihari asked, does it help in healthcare sector? Yes, Srihari ji, it definitely helps in healthcare sector. So one example I can give, like, for example, if you have a heart patient who has a pacemaker in his heart, right? So in terms of its functionality, we may have to rely upon the pacemaker which is sitting inside, and in case any defect, any fault, we may have to operate the patient again and again to identify its functionality and to restore its functionality. But when we have this IoT based sensor along with the pacemaker, then sitting outside, we will be able to monitor and manage the performance of that particular pacemaker. So thereby you will be able to save the patient's life. So whenever in case of any issues with pacemaker, you can get the alerts and you can take the appropriate action from the outside itself rather than operating the patient. Okay, so I hope it answers. And I have a question from Mr. Kaushik. Is automobile or telematics, what is the scope other than driverless car? In automobiles, you can establish connectivity between the various automobiles. So in case if any automobile fails, you can be alerted. Like, for example, if you are going in a car to the airport and suddenly the car breaks down, then instead of you dialing in and again calling up for a backup car, the car itself can alert its nearest neighbors or its other drivers or other cars to immediately come to your rescue. The car can communicate with other cars saying, I am going to the airport and suddenly I have a breakdown. Can somebody please pick my passenger to the airport? That way it can be used. So here the two different cars would be talking. So we don't have to talk anything. Yeah, and Shalini asks, how cybersecurity experts are seeing IoT? Does the use of IoT making common man more vulnerable. Shalini ji, we have the cybersecurity aspects. We will be talking about that in the upcoming slide, so please stay tuned. Sandeep says, what is the impact on software licensing with introduction to IoT? We do not have any software issues here. We will talk about how the IoT is shaping up and what elements we will be using. And any specific software language? Yes, Rajeshji, we will talk about the various softwares and languages shortly. Can we call it IoT if connected products and edge control not connected to internet, but they are wired within themselves? Hemanji, that is not possible, because we will talk about how that connectivity is, and then you can differentiate as to why they can be, why they need to be connected to internet and what is the purpose. Okay, Mr. Tasneem, I will come to your point shortly. Just give me some time. I'm talking about that in the upcoming slides. Megaji, yes, we can say that IoT and AI can work hand in hand to make a lot of things possible. Yeah, Mr. Mohammed, yeah, I truly appreciate your input. Definitely, yes. So let me talk about the further use cases, and I will take up the question answers again. So we can use this IoT solution for smart metering. So where your energy consumption can be calculated, can be monitored, and your bill can be raised then and there on the fly. So that is the commercial usage. And healthcare, we have already discussed, like there are various ways in which we can use this in the healthcare. So all the devices whichever are connected, like for example, even the patient will be connected to various devices like the ECG and the ventilator. So all these different equipments can provide the input in a centralized fashion, where you can correlate the different inputs from various devices and try to understand what is the health condition of a patient. So that correlation is also possible. And when we talk about infrastructure IoT, we can use it for smart waste management, traffic management, and the parking lights, parking's problems can be solved. Like beforehand, you can detect how many parking slots are available. You can also apply it for the pollution control management, right? So there are various such use cases. We will come to the point like how exactly these IoT devices are connected. Like we have got various sensors and actuators which can perform the various tasks. So worldwide, as of now, by 2025, they have created a map or a projection of how many devices are going to be required to be connected. So in all, we have around 34.2 billion devices as of now, which out of which 12.7 billion devices are still non-IoT. It means we are yet to establish the connectivity of those devices. And as of now, almost around 21.5 billion devices are connected. So you can see the potential of the IoT, like how it is going to grow over a period of time. So there is an estimated growth of 10% CAGR. So there is a continuous need for more and more such professionals where we want to apply and implement this IoT in different areas, in different domains. So we have the requirement in manufacturing, healthcare, insurance, banking. Wherever you want, you can apply these IoT solutions. So as I gave you example, like there are various ways in which these IoT can be used. So even in terms of transportation, it can be applied. Even for retail and wholesale, it can be applied. So like that, we have got every field wherein we can apply this IoT concepts in order to determine the various aspects. You want to monitor various aspects about these different use cases. And business point of view, almost around $1.9 trillion of business it is going to generate by 2020. And this is the figure as on today. But when we actually reach 2020, definitely you would see more growth in terms of IoT implementation. Okay, so the main objective of this IoT is to, there are various small devices, but it is making big things possible. Like if I talk about the various other examples, like for example, you have different kinds of inputs coming from the various industries, or you might have different kinds of machinery, right? So all those machines can be supporting these IoT based solutions. In terms of the fuel consumption, you can also apply it to reduce the fuel consumption. Energy consumption can be reduced. So how it is exactly going to happen? So let me come to that solution part, and then I will come back to this particular other slides about the connectivity and how it is going to help us, right? So all the various sensors which you want to deploy or which you want to implement on the field, those devices, those sensors will be connected to our Raspberry Pi board or the Arduino board, and those boards will be integrated with different sensors. Those sensors will be sending the events on the field gateway. This field gateway will be the device which will be on the field interacting with the cloud, and all this data will be being sent to the cloud, whether it is Amazon or whether it is Microsoft or whether it is Google. So any kind of cloud solution you can use, and all this different data will be pushed to the cloud, where you will be able to collect those different events and perform the analytics on those events. And that can be displayed using the user interface, whether it is web UI or whether your mobile phone or your laptop. How it is going to help is, like for example, you might have applied the various sensors in different locations in the industry. Now each such sensor is collecting a lot of inputs. Some sensors might be monitoring the temperature of a room. Some sensors might be monitoring and measuring the temperature of like for example the air conditioner, right? Or if you are in a food industry, then there may be some foods which would be refrigerated. So in some kind of medical cases, like in terms of healthcare, some medicines are very sensitive to the temperature variation. So you want to monitor all these kind of different aspects from remote location. So those sensors can provide the inputs to your cloud, and all these data you can analyze sitting in one place. So as a centralized location sitting on the internet, sitting in the cloud, you are able to monitor and manage all the various sensors across the globe wherever you have implemented. And that analytics on that various inputs can identify any kind of such alerts in case of any variations, in case of any kind of issues at the site. So thereby you can monitor and manage these kind of IoT based devices sitting in one place, and this is how your IoT solution is going to work. Okay, so that is about how the IoT solution functions. Now when coming to the protocol stack, in addition to the IP based protocol stack what we are currently using, like the HTTP, the TCP, IPv4, IPv6, in addition to this protocol stack, we can also use other protocols which are specialized for IoT solutions. Like we will be studying about all these protocols when during our session, and we will be able to understand and the functioning of each protocol we will talk about in those sessions. Okay, so excuse me. So some people were asking, like, what are the various hardware which are required in IoT, right? And what are the various sensors? Are they normal ones? Yes, the sensors are normal ones, the ones which already the industry has manufactured in large numbers. So we just have to integrate those sensors with our electronic solutions, with our hardware, and pump in all this data and events to the cloud and try to monitor and manage. So in terms of hardware, IoT solutions supports heterogeneity, like irrespective of what hardware it is, which manufacturer has manufactured, and what kind of software it is, whether it is Java, whether it is Python, whether it is C. So any kind of software or any kind of hardware can be supporting this IoT solution. There's no specificity, there's no specific thing which is mandatory in IoT. So that is making this solution even more attractive, because we are able to integrate multiple different solutions, different kinds of hardware, different kinds of software as per your need, your requirement, your expertise. So that is the advantage of this IoT architecture. So this is an architecture in a nutshell. So here we have the various devices and data sources. So you can use all the existing IoT devices. You can also integrate IP capable devices with your other equipment. And all these devices will be sending the data, pumping in the traffic to your cloud gateway. Using the cloud gateway, you can separate out all those events depending upon what you want to analyze. Here we can analyze the events in two parts. Like we have hot path analysis, where you can monitor these events on the fly. Like suppose a temperature variation has been detected and suddenly you want to take action, right? So that is called hot path analysis. And those devices, those events which you want to store in a storage and want to conduct analysis after a few days or few months, then that is called as cold path analysis. And in addition to the analytical techniques what we have in general, we can also apply the machine learning algorithms to identify, classify, and correlate the information which you are generating from these different IoT solutions. And finally, give the output to the visualization tools and software, where you can derive the meaningful information which is relevant to the business heads. They may want to identify how much cost we have incurred by applying this IoT solution, whether this solution is cost benefit or not. In case of manpower utilization, whether the number of hours that the machine was in production and how many hours the operator was present near the machine, whether there is any issue in terms of manpower, any issue in terms of the various raw material supply being given to the machines. So all these different aspects we can determine by doing this analytics. So let me talk about our curriculum and what we are going to study, because there are many questions, many curious people who are asking me about lot of things, like what is there in the IoT, what all things we can learn. So let me touch upon that first. So when we talk about IoT, as I was telling you, we have to establish the electronic circuitry, electronic devices we are connecting, right? So some of you may or may not be aware about the way the electronic circuits need to be established, the identification of transistors, resistors, and their various properties. So for that reason, we are driving up this course right from the basic fundamentals of electronics. So I will be making you understand each and every element of electronics, like what is a resistor, what is a transistor, what is a diode, and how it is going to help in our electronics. Like for example, you have electrolytic capacitor, you have a normal capacitors, and you have NPN PNP diodes, NPN PNP transistors, you have zener diode, normal diode, right? So these basic electronics we will be talking about in our fundamentals, and then we will be talking about what are the various sensors and actuators. Like I gave the example for soil detection, we have soil sensors, and we have DHT11 sensor for temperature calculation or temperature detection. So like that, we will be having various sensors. Like one best example which you use day in day out is your remote control of a TV. So in your TV, you have a IR sensor. So whenever you change your channel, that action will be performed accordingly. Those actionable things are called as actuators. So whenever you want to perform some action, the electronic input converting into physical action, that job will be done by the actuator, right? So those things we will be understanding. And then we will talk about the Arduino and Raspberry Pi boards and their capabilities, and how these various sensors can be integrated, how the data exchange can take place, how the various protocols we have just seen in previous slide, how they can be applied for communication and information exchange. So those things we will be learning, and we will be learning about the Python programming basics and Arduino IDE programming basics. So believe me guys, even those who are new into this electronics or Python, rest assured, they will definitely be able to catch up, because we are taking it from the ground up. Okay, and then we will be talking about the various IoT device management techniques, like how we can monitor and manage devices. In case of the updates, in case of the new updates for those respective devices, how we can push the updates from remote place. And some of you were asking about the security aspects, right? How to ensure security for the IoT solutions. So those security solutions also, we have a session where we can apply, how we can apply, what are the various techniques, what are the various tools. So all those security related discussions also we have in our sessions. And how we can use this AWS and Azure cloud solution to monitor and manage this IoT. So those things also we will be talking about. So this is a course overview in a nutshell. So let me go back to the previous slides, which I skipped just for your understanding. I thought of touching.
Rahul, hi. So a couple of people are asking about, so you have mentioned about the overview of the course, right? So is there any place where they can go to get the detailed course content? So
Anand, we have our website where we have the detailed breakup of the various courses. So guys, you can go to this our organization's website. We have sfjbs.com. So let me show you what those detailed inputs are. Like I'll be going into training. Once we click on training, we have the various list of courses which we are taking up. Okay, so in that we have Internet of Things. Okay, so here you can, I will expand all these. So whatever I have shown, it was in a nutshell. So if we talk about the specifics, right? So we will be talking about all this introduction part, how the data flow happens, how to understand architecture and the various sensors, and how we will be connecting them on the Raspberry Pi for and Arduino. For that we have the hands-on labs. And when we talk about the Arduino, we will understand it thoroughly, like what are the internals, what are the APIs and the input output schemes, the different pin structure. Okay, and we will be doing some hands-on labs, like integrating the LED, powering on the LED, powering off using your programming technique. Okay, so we will be writing the code for on the Arduino that will switch on, switch off the LED. So we will be experimenting that, and then we will be seeing how to monitor the environment, like the temperature, monitoring temperature variation, those things we will see. And in Raspberry Pi also we will be seeing like what is the operating system which is helping in Raspberry Pi boot up, how to do the Python programming, and the various input output of the Raspberry Pi and the web stack. So all these things we will be understanding and learning as part of our curriculum. So in terms of protocol, the different protocols that we can use in this solution, and specific to IoT we have MQTT protocol, so that thing also we will be learning. And in addition to that, like the messaging communication, how we can establish the messaging, what are the various protocols, channels, and how to use the different SDKs which are available to us in programming this entire solution, right? And how to do the device management, what are the various methods, like we have a direct method and we have the device simulation. So these hands-on we will be doing it. Okay, and in terms of the Azure IoT Hub, the various fundamentals of how to build the, how to write the SDKs, how to use it for connectivity with your cloud, and the various pre-configured solutions, management tools. So like that, we have got each and everything which can bring you from the ground up, right? So in case if you want to just visit, you can visit our website sfjbstraining.com/product/IoT training. So that will help you anytime. If not after the session also, you may want to understand and you may want to make a note of these things. So you can definitely log into our site and you can see what are these things in detail. So we will be also touching upon the AWS suite in addition to Azure. And in analytics, we'll be learning about the basics of big data. We will understand how it can help in gathering these various events and how we can process them, right? And we will talk about the various security aspects, about the architecture, about the endpoint security, and various implementation things. And we will also learn about the Microsoft BI tool. So where we will use this for virtual visualization of the various inputs which we are gathering from the field, and how to store them, and how to analyze them. So these things we will be learning in detail in our curriculum. Okay, so that is about the details. So let me touch upon the other thing. So why this IoT has become successful nowadays? Why we are talking about this? Now see, in the past, you have seen that our internet's bandwidth was less. Electronics continuous research is going on. We are moving towards further miniaturization at every generation. You are seeing that the mobiles earlier were big, now they are very small, they are very handy. And the electronics that we are using are very powerful as well. And you have seen the growth of the 4G, right? We have 2G, 3G, 4G, now we are talking about 5G. So these different sectors have brought in together the power and made easy for the IoT to be implemented on a large scale. Now, initially, even when we thought about the ATM solutions, right? The ATM solutions earlier were not possible till the time our this internet-based solutions were not in place. By using these different types of connectivity, like using your RF connectivity, using your leased lines, using your IPs, we have established ATMs even in the corner of a village. In a corner of our country, in a remote village, we are able to set up. So similarly, the IoT boom started and we are able to use the IoT mainly because we have these advancements and these different related fields. And now, due to this continuous large data which is getting generated, we have the supporting infrastructure like big data, which is making it possible. So all these different solutions have now brought in together, which is helping us in applying this IoT solution on a large scale. So what are those technological drivers? Technological drivers are any wireless that you are using or any connected internet that you want to use. Whether it is wired or wireless, it doesn't matter. As long as your Raspberry is connected, it will help you to gather the inputs, collect the inputs, and analyze those. Okay. So as we know, IPv4 is limited in number, like already we have exhausted, but we have the IPv6, which can still be used to monitor and manage this IoT solutions. Since IPv6 is around 2 power 128, so we have huge number of IP addresses which can cater to our growing needs of the IoT devices. Like they are database administrators, how this solution can help them or how they can use this to upskill, right? So basically when we talk about the IoT, as I have discussed, so there are various elements in this. Like we have the software, we have the hardware, and in addition to that, we have the various analytics and the databases that we are going to use, right? So when we talk about those, if you see, like, we have various elements in this. Like this is a Microsoft Azure IoT services. So nowadays, even the Amazon and the Microsoft and Google, they have already started giving the tools which can make our IoT implementation easier, right? So this tool indicates all those elements that we would require in our solution. So all the devices that we have, the electronic devices or non-electronic, like suppose we have CCTV camera and we have the vehicles. So all the different devices can contribute to IoT. And any sensor which is connected on these devices, like your car and your CCTV camera, those can provide inputs. Those can provide the data as feed to your various solutions that we have or various services that we have on the cloud. Like in terms of Microsoft Azure, we have event hubs, we have service bus, and we have any other external data sources which can be integrated, which will establish the device connectivity. And in terms of storage, we have SQL database, or we have blob storages, we have document DB. So like that, we have got various storages. Now, whenever we talk about the different roles that we are currently performing, right? Now, you may be a database expert. Now you want to build a career in IoT. So obviously, whatever database we are integrating here, this database is collecting huge amount of data from the field. The data can be in gigabytes, megabytes, or terabytes. So obviously, your expertise in terms of administration of database is helpful here. You can take the backup, you can define the backup policies, you can do the recovery of databases, right? And if you are a data analytics expert, we have the machine learning and the HD insight and integration. So you can apply your techniques for classification and to derive meaningful information about those different events that we are getting from the field, right? And if you are an app developer, you can develop the different apps for visualization of all these different analytical output. And you can present it using the BI solution and any other solution to the business heads. So like that, we have got the expertise, whatever you have is required here in IoT. IoT is not isolated, guys. It is not isolated from your IT industry. Like if you talk about any other solution, right? For example, even if you talk about ATM, ATM also has the IP address based connectivity. So there we need network engineer to install and implement the ATM. We need the experts to identify in case of any operations which need to be performed, like upgrading of the operating system, okay? And those guys who want to troubleshoot, who help in troubleshooting the operating system solutions, the ATM solutions. So like that, every field now is depending upon the IT. It is not isolated from IT. So all of you guys who have the relevant skill set, you can contribute to this IoT solutions in a large extent. So similar to Amazon, we have AWS services also. So every cloud service provider is offering those services so that we can use them and we can build the various solutions. So in terms of jobs, almost around 1.2 million jobs are projected by 2025. This is as on today. The number is as on today, but it is going to grow. And in terms of the designations in the career, we have various designations. We have Chief Internet of Things Officer, who is equivalent to CISO or CEO or CXO. And we have the designers, we have developers, and we have electronic engineers who work on the field. So those things are also there. And these are the various IoT and allied fields where you can command average salary of around not less than $90,000. So we have all these expertise which are required who can contribute in IoT. We need machine learning engineer, we need big data engineer, we need Node.js developer, we need data scientist, we need security engineers, right? So all these different skills that you possess can be applied in IoT solutions. So that's all about from my end. So let me take up any other questions that we have. So far I had scrolled through and addressed most of the questions, but in case if you still have any more questions, please feel free to ask and I will take up those. I understand we are already overshooting the time. I sincerely apologize because I was late. So what is the role of a QA guy in IoT? Manish, any solution will definitely need a QA. So when we are integrating the various applications, like the visualization applications, developing the developers will be using the skills to develop those tools, then definitely we may have to test also, right? So definitely QA guy is required in IoT solution. And yet in some guys are asking about other things, other questions which you can address, like for example, they want to understand about other courses. So I will leave those questions to you. And
yes,
about blockchain and all that they are asking. So okay. And how important does open source technologies play an important role in IoT? Arvind, whatever these technologies we have, we can use it to build IoT solutions. So as I discussed previously, right, we are heterogeneous. Like this IoT solutions are heterogeneous. Any hardware, any software can be used to build IoT solution. And Harshal says, what is scope for project management for IoT? Harshal, now when we talk about this IoT solution, as now you can visualize the scale, right? We can use the IoT for the entire industry, for the big factories. So obviously you may have to
this particular session after it ends. Also, you will all be getting a certificate of participation for this webinar, which you can post on your LinkedIn or other places. Great. So yes, I think we are good to go. Also participants, we have another session on AI tomorrow, AI and machine learning, right? So that's again a detailed thing. So it will be a 1 hour session from 11 to 12. We again have a huge turn up from a lot of corporates tomorrow as well. So in case you would like to join, if you want to learn about AI and machine learning also, do visit us tomorrow. Anything else that you would like to mention, Rahul?
Yeah, there are a few questions related to technology. I'll quickly address that. There is a question about what is the role of data scientist? See, now we have huge amount of data that is getting generated. So obviously data scientist expertise is required to analyze and understand and correlate all these different kinds of events and to alert us about the various issues that might be happening, or to identify and calculate whether the IoT solution was profitable or not. So for that, data scientist role is definitely useful. And Subra asks, what software technologies will be used in IoT? Subra, we can use any technology. We have C, C++, Java, Hash, C, C Sharp, Python. So any technology can be used in your coding, because our main IoT solution is all about electronics. And in terms of software, you can use any software to correlate this information or correlate these events and integrate with your any of the solution that you have. Aminas asks, just like Microsoft Azure IoT, are there any big players? Nowadays, everybody is giving the IoT services so that they want to capture the market share. They don't want to be left behind. So your Amazon, Google, Microsoft, everybody is offering this IoT services. Mainly, it is nothing but the infrastructure that they are enabling us to make our task easier. So they are just giving those services which we will be using it on the cloud, right? So that way. And the leader is, of course, right now there is no specific leader as such, because everybody is using many solutions. And Harish asks, do we need data analyst for IoT? Okay, so data analyst definitely required. So this is the same question. And how can an RPA developer contribute to IoT? Kiran, the RPA can be used in line with IoT. So where you can automate all these robotic processes by integrating these IoT sensors, IoT solutions, right? So in what term data scientist would be helped to IoT? I think I have already addressed that. So where do Windows or Linux system admin fit in IoT? Kamlesh, like any kind of system administration is required. Like you can help in terms of, like, in case of any users need to be created, you know, like there are various IDAM policies which we have to implement even for IoT. So you can help in creating the users, giving the relevant policies, giving the relevant accesses, right, and ensuring that authentication processes are applied. So for any kind of user who is accessing IoT, his role need to be created, he need to be assigned permissions. So system admin can help there. Yeah, I think I have addressed all the questions. So how it is beneficial for non-technical background? Sanjay, like since we are taking this from the ground up, so definitely you can understand and you can help in terms of implementation aspects, right? So any link between cybersecurity with IoT? Yes, Kiran, like cybersecurity has to be applied on IoT, because now when even the IoT devices are getting hooked up to internet, there are chances that the attackers can use these IoT solutions to penetrate into your actual networks, your data networks. So we will address that as I have walked you through the course contents. So we have the security topic for almost, I think, 8th or 9th day, we will be talking about that. Definitely, yes, it is very useful and required in IoT solution. Abhishek asks, is programming necessary for enrolling in IoT? If you know the basics, right, like the for loop, if loop, that is sufficient. Yes, Abhishek, you can definitely make your career, because in nowadays, there are many tools and techniques which are coming up. You have to integrate. You don't have to really code, right? So you can definitely help. Who will have the final control? Shirish, I apologize, because your question has scrolled up due to many questions. If you can please repeat the question, I would be able to address that. Ranjit asks, do we provide job placement? I think I leave that question to Yatin. So you can write the question to him. You can email him and he will be able to reply to that. Shirish, we are almost at the end of session. If you can repeat the question, I will definitely address it. Final control of what? I'm not able to get your question.
I think we need to
The cloud, the person who is monitoring and managing the cloud solution, he will have the central control. in filmmaking devices and entertainment technologies, how IoT helps. IoT can help you by identifying these various inputs, like in on the fly, they can monitor and manage the on-screen things. Okay, so they can correlate this input to the cloud. That way it can help. And I'm electronic engineer in IT industry for 15 years, especially in enterprise application integration. How I can mold my career. Ravindra, I have given you n number of options where you can contribute. So as an electronics engineer, you can help in designing the circuits. You can help in integrating these circuits and applying these circuits on the field. So the guys, IoT is going to change the future. Definitely, it has got a great potential. It would become like a mobile phone. So earlier, mobile phone was very pricey, but now you are seeing the mobile phone has got many, many useful things. Like you are able to use multiple apps. You are able to use it for booking the movies, tickets, booking your train tickets. So similarly, IoT is going to change our future, the way we are going to use it, the way we are going to interact with each other. Everything would be automated, and definitely it has got great potential, and we have a need for large number of people to contribute to this field. So that is about the power of IoT. So I welcome you all. So I would wish each one of you can join this session, and we can definitely come out with a great number and quality of the outcome in terms of the IoT projects and IoT designed solutions. Okay, so thank you all. Thanks for your patience, and thanks for giving me opportunity to express my views. Okay, I thank you all. So please join the session, and we can go much more deeper, much more details we can talk about. Okay, so thank you so much.